On episode 2 of the 8th season from The Big Bang Theory, Sheldon was testing Howard to see if he was smart enough to take his classes. During this inquiry, Sheldon asked,
"Do you know how to integrate x squared times e to the minus x without looking it up?"
"I'd use Feynman's trick, differentiate under the integral sign."
"Yeah, okay."
But do you understand what does it mean? Today, we're solving the same integral using Feynman's integration trick. We know math is all about simplification, and that's exactly what Feynman was trying to do. So he proposed with his trick that we could find a certain function of a that when derivated would assume the same value as our original integral. So let me show you how it works. So let's call our function of a this integral here, the integral of e to the negative ax dx. See that this function is similar to our original one, but it's not the same, right? So what we can do here, we can derivate this function of a in respect to a. And when we do it, we have the derivation in respect to a of e to the negative ax. And the derivation of this thing here inside would be equal negative x times e to the negative ax. So our first derivative would be this integral here, okay? Now it's a little bit more similar to our original, but it's not quite there. So let us differentiate the function again. Okay, now we're taking the second derivative of our original function in respect to a. If we derivate this thing inside here, we'll get x squared times e to the negative ax dx. Okay, so our second derivative is the integral of x squared times e to the negative ax dx. And see, now that's this function here is almost the same as our original. Now note that if a equals 1, we have exactly our original integral. So that's what Feynman proposed us to do. Okay, that's his trick. We want to find a certain function of a that's quite similar to our original one, or is exactly our original one when a assumes a certain value. So in this case here, if we differentiate our first function, the function of a, 2 times and makes a equals 1, we have exactly our original integral. But why? Why we're doing this? Well, this function here, into the integral of a to the negative ax dx, is a much simpler integration, right? So if we integrate now this function of a in terms of a, we'll get a simple result, which is negative 1 over a times e to the negative ax plus c. And now we can start from here. We know that our first derivative of this function over here will be this, e to the negative ax times ax plus 1 over a squared. I'm not going through this derivation, okay? I'm going to leave it over here. You can pause the video if you want to take a look at it, but it's quite simple. I'm just doing the product rule here. So we have the derivative of the first function times the second plus the first function times the derivative of the second, okay? And doing some factoring, you get to this result here. Now, if you derivate this function once more, all right, you get this result here. It looks big, it looks complicated, but it's not, okay? It's a big derivation, it's a long derivation, but we're just applying the product rule again, okay? And it's easy, right? It's much easier to derivate than integrate. Now remember that when a equals 1, we have our original integral. So I'm basically saying that when this function here, the second derivative, equals 1, it will be exactly the value of our first integral. So we just solved our integral, because this integral here is the second derivative of our function of a when a equals 1. So that's the famous Feynman's integration trick that was mentioned in the Big Bang Theory. I hope you enjoyed and see you next time.
Thank you for watching our video. Stay tuned for more math topics and don't forget to subscribe.